the 60-kilogram weight division.
Quintana on paper is a clear-cut favorite, has the credentials, has the experience. Jokar, qualified Iran at this weight class, placed fifth in the first Olympic qualifier, but in a match in the Olympic finals, going for a gold medal, records really don't mean anything. He has obviously, Jokar, been wrestling very, very well throughout this tournament, won a wild match in the semifinals over his Japanese opponent, 5-4.
2 3-minute periods in the Olympic finals matches, just like everywhere else, a wrestler must score at least 3 points in the regulation time by the time we get to 6 minutes, or they go into overtime.
Quintana, to his credit, has given up only 1 point thus far in this tournament. And there, referee asking for a caution, saying Jokar was fleeing the mat under attack, but that is not confirmed. Wrestling continues.
Just over 2 minutes, and you can hear in the background the whistles of the Iranian crowd. Attacked there by Quintana, and he will get the first point in this match. Takedown.
Just reached out with one arm, Russ, and picked up Jokar's right leg and finished with a nice trip. I mean, Quintana's technique looks so solid, and obviously he's extremely powerful.
And if here he comes leads, in. Here's that shot, Jeff.
One arm he's holding onto that leg, able to get it up in the air, used his left leg to trip Jokar to the mat.
And we continue in the center of the mat. Just over a minute and a half remaining here, almost halfway through this first period. The Cuban has struck first, 1-0. He's in again on a single leg shot.
Same leg as before. Jokar's right leg, and now the Cuban out to a 2-0 lead. And I thought he might go after a gut wrench right here, but I think he wants to play the takedown game.
Well, you would have to say that Quintana is the most impressive here. He was second in the world, so brings the most credentials in. Here's that shot.
Working Jokar's head, unbalances him, takes him out of his stance, seizes the leg, gets the takedown. And the stance is your first line of defense. Stay in a solid stance. And if you take a shot at that, it's going right into the teeth of a defense.
And again, I thought we had a passivity call, but the official just straightening out some things. A hand on the singlet there, that's not allowed, but breaks off quickly. Under a minute remaining in the first period.
Look at that. Unbelievable athleticism by Quintana. Just going around the side, knocking Jokar down and scoring another point. 3-0 now you score. Quintana very much in control. The Iranian crowd very quiet right now. And Rush, you got to give the Iranian crowd a lot of credit in terms of class. If one of their wrestlers lose, and we'll probably see it with Quintana here, the way he's wrestling, they're going to applaud him. They recognize good, solid wrestling, and they appreciate it.
Always make good friends in international wrestling. Get the job done on the mat, and everything else off the mat is different. 30 seconds remaining in this match. This for the gold medal. Yandro Quintana ahead right now, 3-0.
First period, Linson, and look at the power of Quintana. Boy, he's lightning quick, and when he gets a hold.
Seconds remaining in this match. This for the gold medal. Yandro Quintana ahead right now, 3-0.
First period, Linson, and look at the power of Quintana. Boy, he's lightning quick, and when he gets a hold of the leg, he's easily getting it up in the air, and it's tough to hop on one foot when a man charging into you.
Tremendous power, and the more experienced Quintana here really takes advantage of this situation.
Moves to the head first of Jokar, then goes underneath to finish the takedown.
Quintana was a three-time Pan American gold medalist, so he's been at the international level for a long time. And right now he has dominant control of this match. 60 kilograms gold medal, too late. He's ahead 4-0.
Scan security solutions from Computer Associates.
Gold medal match at 60 kilograms, 132 pounds. Yandro Quintana of Cuba in charge of this match over Masoud Jokar of Iran. And right at the end of the period, big shot.
What a wonderful technique by Quintana. No points, but you saw him pull on the head. If the head moves towards the mat, less weight on the feet, legs easier to lift. Quintana with really tremendous technical skill, putting on a clinic.
And that action was too late at the whistle. The period ended, so wasted a little bit of energy, but really displayed his talents. Cuba, a very strong team in international wrestling, both in freestyle here and the Greco-Roman discipline. They were coached many years ago by Soviet personnel and have maintained that tradition, always a factor in world and Olympic competition. Quintana was second in the worlds. He was a three-time Pan American gold medalist, so he's the more experienced. Jokar really qualified by being fifth in the qualifier, 26 years of age, but really not having a lot of experience at the international level, and I think it's showing, Jeff.
Well, against the likes of Quintana, yeah, it looks as though Jokar is inexperienced, but he is a tough athlete. But you got to hand it to Quintana. I think right now this is the most dominant display, particularly in a final, of any wrestler I can remember here. We saw Ibrahim and Greco-Roman just decimate the field. Quintana here only giving up 1 point thus far in the entire tournament.
And we're going to have a passivity call, and Jokar of Iran will be put down in the parterre position. The referees have determined that he is not being aggressive enough, and the Cuban will get an opportunity here to work a turn and try to get some more points on the board.
This is the only place where Quintana thus far has not scored, is on the mat. Really outstanding in this, in the technical skill he has when he's on his feet looking for takedowns.
And he is only 24 years of age, so a seasoned veteran already at a very young age. Under a minute and a half remaining in this match. This for the gold medal here at 132 pounds.
These lighter weight classes, extremely quick. Pound for pound, extremely powerful. Thus far, Jokar unable to mount any kind of defense to threaten Quintana.
And you can hear his partisan fans in the background here trying to encourage him on, but he's really getting attacked by Quintana more than he is launching any sort of an offense himself. Well, under
time,
a minute.
That time, Jokar kind of got a feel for the offense of Quintana, was able to counter that attack as it went out of bounds. And that's what it takes for us, you're right, experience. Now that Jokar has wrestled Quintana, he can come up with a better game plan, implement better tactics. He still could possibly win this match with a big move, but thus far he has shown no indication that he has solved the riddle of Quintana's defense.
Well, he can't get anything going on his feet, and he hasn't had an opportunity to do much in the top position. So Quintana of Cuba, as time is running down, less than 30 seconds remaining in this match at 132 pounds at 60 kilograms. Right now they're continually telling him to be aggressive, but no passivity call. Quintana, just a verbal warning.
Yeah, Quintana is not going to take a risk ahead 4-0 with 15 seconds left. It's not worth it. Tie your opponent up. Try to get the time to wind down.
And he's clapping for himself. He can already sense the victory. 10 seconds remaining in this match. He can taste that gold medal.
What an impressive performance by Quintana, only giving up 1 point in winning the gold.
And he is your Olympic champion, 60 kilograms, 132 pounds. That's the best performance he's ever had in international competition. He adds that to his silver medal, but this one is just a little bit sweeter, and you can tell how important it is to the coaches of Cuba.